Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming a Sephora wishlist video. It is April, and usually April brings a Sephora sale, and I don't know if they are gonna do one this year, so I just thought it would be fun if I made a wishlist and we could like pretend shop, because I don't honestly know that I can afford to buy all these things that are on my wishlist right now, but it's always so fun to see what people are eyeing on Sephora. And yeah, I'm always on the app like checking things out, and yeah, I just thought it'd be fun. I really haven't bought much from Sephora this year, which I am proud of. I'm trying to buy less things. It's not always the easiest thing to do, but yeah, let's go ahead and see what's on my wish list. So the first thing I saw, this is pretty new. I saw Trendmood posted that they've gotten a bunch of like skincare tools on Sephora. So Sephora Collection came out with a skincare fridge, and I think it's really cute. It's $60, so I probably wouldn't buy it unless I can get a really good deal on it. There's no reviews on it right now, and you know, a skincare fridge is really something extra. It's not a necessity. I do keep like my under eye patches and the Glam Glow hydrating mask in my fridge, like where I store like our food, in like a separate area, but I like it. So I like having cooled products, like chilled skincare products, but it's not like a necessity. So if I had a spare $60, I would buy it, but it's not like I need it kind of thing, you know? And it looks like Sephora Collection redid all of their brushes from what I can tell. So they launched a new brush line, and this brush just caught my eye, the Pro Bronzer number 80 brush. It looks so big and fluffy, and I just want to like run that thing in a bronzer and then like put it all over my face. So I've got my eye on it. It is $34. It's a little more than what I like to spend on brushes, to be very honest with you guys. So I may not go for it right away, but I have it on my loves list, so maybe I'll keep my eye out for it. Maybe it'll go on like some kind of discount eventually. The next thing I have on here is something I can never imagine having enough money to purchase, but this is the Dyson Coil hair straightener for $4.99. That is such an insane price tag, but I was getting my hair done and I know my hairstylist loves the Dyson hair dryer, so I was asking her about the straightener and I asked her if she had heard anything about it. She said that she's been reading all the reviews and it seems like it works really great for people, but she was nervous to get it for her salon because it doesn't seem like it holds a charge for very long, and usually at a salon they need to have their straighteners plugged in all day long. So I don't think she's gonna get it, but I've got my eye on it. I just don't see myself purchasing it, to be very honest with you guys. But yeah, if you guys have it, let me know your thoughts. The next thing I have my eye on is the Urban Decay Stay Naked Weightless Foundation. Now, I love that foundation in the summertime when it came out, and I feel like the shade I have now is a little too dark. I have 60 cool something is the shade, and it's a little tan for me right now, so I thought maybe if I went like a whole shade level down, I could find the right shade. So we'll see. It's not something I need. I just panned a foundation bottle and I have a few more I need to use up. So right now I'm just focusing on finishing up some foundations instead of like buying more foundations. Another thing I would really love to pick up on sale is a Fenty Beauty Fly Pencil Longwear Pencil Eyeliner. I went into a Sephora, or I went into my Sephora here in Fargo and swatched some of those eye pencils, and they were so creamy and beautiful. It was really hard for me to say no to them, but I did walk away, and yeah, maybe someday I'll get more, or like on a sale I'll get more. But for right now, I just have them on my wish list. Another thing I have my eye on is the Fenty Beauty Matchstick Glow Skin Stick. So this launched for a little bit on Sephora app, but it's called Pearl, which is an iridescent pink, and it just looks like it's a, I don't know, it's like it almost looks like you could just buy it to put like more glow on your face even if you don't have any makeup on. I don't know, I'm kind of curious about it, so I will maybe consider picking it up. And then I really want the Glass Slipper clear gloss from Fenty Beauty. I had kind of talked myself out of it, but again, my hairstylist was talking about how much she loved it, and she's now convinced me that I need to own it, so I think I'm going to be owning it soon. Oh my gosh, they have the Fenty blushes on here. I think I'm definitely going to be signing up for a notification email. These are not out yet, but they might be out when you're seeing this video. So I think Fargo Flush definitely caught my attention. And I kind of like Cool Berry. And then Daiquiri Dip is like a beautiful... Ooh, these are so pretty. I definitely think I'm going to get Rose Latte. So I'm going to add that to my list of notifications. And Summer Wine looks beautiful as well. There's definitely like shades that I just are like my go-to shades when it comes to cream products and like blush products and face products. So just going to add all of those. And then they also have the bronzers on here. So let me see. I think I would probably be Honey Glaze, which is a medium to tan skin tone. Or Macchiato. I think maybe Honey Glaze. I bought the wrong shade in the Huda one. When I purchased it, I was so mad because the shade I ended up picking up from Huda in her cream bronzer is a little too dark for me. So I really deeply regret never having taken that back to Sephora. So those are some of the Fenty products on my list. And you know how Fenty is? They like release stuff like here and there. It's like they don't really have like... I don't know, like big drops. They always drop like a few products here, a few products there, which I don't really mind because I'd rather buy a few things at separate occasions than having these big overwhelming collections to pick from. So, you know, if it's working for her, that's cool. The next thing I really want is the Tatcha Liquid Silk Canvas. And this is their new liquid formula for the primer that they have really become known for. So many people swear by this primer and I am so curious to try it. So far I've heard nothing but good things, so I kind of have my eye on that particular primer. And then I've always wanted to try Jouer Blush Bouquet. They've never had shades that I felt like were dark enough for me. I feel like this one is honestly a little too deep, but I'm kind of curious. It's the shade Passion. You guys know I love a good shimmery orange. And I feel like I can go in with a light hand, so we'll see. $30 seems like a lot though, so I haven't decided, but I kind of want it. So another thing I want to pick up, this is kind of a replacement, and if Sephora does have their sale, I'll definitely pick one of these up, is a shower cap. And I have the black one, but now I want this, the Minx. The one I have is getting, you know, a little bit old. There's nothing wrong with it, it's just that I kind of want a new one, so I may get this one. It's a $43 shower cap, which does sound kind of ridiculous, but I don't always wash my hair when I take a shower, so I like having a shower cap so my hair doesn't get wet, and this one really kind of like seals my whole head, so I really, really like that. The next thing that is on my list is the Fresh Sugar Hydrating Lip Balm in the flavor Lime Mint. You guys know I'm a sucker for lime, and mostly lime. I have the Laneige. This is the, what is this, the apple lime. And of course, it's green, so I'm like obsessed with it. And for Fresh, I have three of their lip balms. So I have lemon, I have coconut, and then I have a little sample of caramel. I, of course, wanted coconut. Look, there's a nice big dip in there because I use this quite a bit. I leave it on my vanity, and then when I do my skincare down here, I always put some lip balm on because, you know, I like to hydrate my lips. So I definitely want lime mint if I can get it on sale. But since I have so many, I won't get it at full price. So I'm going to wait that out. We'll see what happens. So I kind of have the Pat McGrath concealer on my wish list. And if I can get it on sale, I might pick it up because I've heard good things, and so now I'm really, really curious about it. The next thing I want to try is the Cinema Secrets Brush Cleaning Shampoo. So I think this is for when you want to deep clean your brushes. I have their, like, Quick Clean, the one that's like you spray it on a paper towel and you clean your brushes with that. I use that a lot on like a daily basis to clean my brushes between deep cleaning them, but I think I would really like to try the brush cleaning shampoo because I genuinely love their like instant brush cleaner. So kind of curious about that. I really, really, really love this Dior Backstage Rosy Glow Blush in the shade Coral. It just looks beautiful. It's $37 and I'm honestly a little bit concerned that it won't show up on my skin tone. So I have not purchased it, but I genuinely like salivate over that thing in my list, and I constantly look at it, so it is on there to purchase. I know I'm definitely gonna buy this, the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector in medium to deep for medium to dark skin when I can get it on sale. It's $32, so I don't wanna just buy it right away, but I definitely have my eye on it to purchase during the next sale that I come across. And then the Estee Lauder Futurist Hydra Rescue Moisturizing Foundation. I really wanna try this. I love the Estee Lauder like foundation, especially double wear. So I'm really, really curious to try this one. I think I saw Mel Thompson review it and said it was really good. So I definitely wanna pick it up. Another thing I wanna try from Tatcha is the serum stick treatment and touch up balm. I don't exactly know that that's something I need, but I'm curious to try it out and see. So we'll see if I have the spare cash, I may pick it up. I also really want to try the Buxom Wanderlust Primer Infused Blushes. I've heard so many YouTubers comment on how good it is, so I'm really, really, really interested in trying it out. We'll see. There's so many other blushes coming out, like the Fenty ones, so maybe that will move that off my list. And then the very last thing on my wish list that I want, and I won't get it full price, I want to wait for a sale, because I feel like this palette, the time has come and gone, so nobody's going to really want to see a review, but I kind of want to have it for like my collection, is the Natasha Denona Mini Glam Eyeshadow Palette. It reminds me a lot of the ColourPop Coconut Palette, so I probably don't need it, but I just love the size of those palettes, and I feel like it's such a cute palette that I just love to have in my collection, so I'll probably pick that up during a sale when the time comes. So yeah, that is everything that's really on my wish list, especially if they do have a Sephora sale in April, which they typically do, so I'll keep my eye out. I'll let you guys know if I hear anything. Definitely, you know, if you follow me on Instagram, I'll definitely post on there as well. But yeah, this is my current Sephora wish list. Let me know some of your wish list items. It doesn't have to be from Sephora. I just love using my Sephora app as a shopping list or like a wish list. So I just thought it would be fun to share with you guys. And yeah, that's it. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I hope you are having a wonderful day, and I will see you in my next video soon. Bye guys!